The nervous system, neurons, and brain cells. This is a quick video on the nervous system, brain cells like neurons and glial cells, and protein production. The nervous system is separated into the central nervous system, which encompasses the brain and spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system, which are the neurons in the rest of the body. The peripheral nervous system is further divided into the somatic system, which is used for sensory input and voluntary motor output. And the peripheral nervous system has the autonomic system, like the sympathetic and parasympathetic systems. The sympathetic system is in charge of the four Fs, which are fight, flight, fear, and fornicate. And these increase blood pressure, alertness, and decreases digestive function. The parasympathetic is in charge of non-emergency functions like growth, energy storage, digestion, and the immune system. Both the sympathetic and parasympathetic work in opposition to each other. The sympathetic system has ganglion cells that release hormones. These ganglion cells are short presynaptically and long postsynaptically, and they rely on ACH, norepinephrine, and epinephrine, which is also known as adrenaline. The sympathetic is also closer to the site of communication compared to the parasympathetic. The parasympathetic system has long axons prior to the ganglion and have short axons postsynaptically. This system only uses ACH. The parasympathetic originates from the cranial and lower spine region, thus having to travel longer and doesn't necessarily have simultaneous effects, being a slower process. The brain communicates to the body through two ways. It could send fast and targeted messages through the peripheral nervous system, or it could use hormones which are slow but has a more widespread effect, traveling via the bloodstream. Hormones are chemicals that can influence what other cells should do or produce. In the brain, there are two glands that release hormones, they being the pineal and pituitary gland. The pineal gland releases melatonin, which regulates sleep and wakefulness. The pituitary gland is connected to the hypothalamus, which regulates homeostasis, and the gland is separated into two parts, the anterior and posterior. The posterior pituitary releases oxytocin and vasopressin, which was delivered and created by the hypothalamus. The anterior pituitary, on the other hand, creates hormones, but the hypothalamus regulates its release. For example, it releases ACTH only when the hypothalamus releases CRH. ACTH then releases into the bloodstream and reaches the adrenal glands, which produces cortisol, the stress hormone. Two important brain structures to consider, which nourishes and protects the brain, include the blood-brain barrier and the cerebrospinal fluid. The blood-brain barrier is made up of tightly packed endothelial cells that form walls of the capillaries and regulates what molecules are allowed to come through, letting in small uncharged molecules, amino acids, glucose, oxygen, and also taking out carbon dioxide. They also let in lipophilic drugs, but they block out charged and large molecules. Cerebral spinal fluid, on the other hand, is a fluid produced by the choroid plexus in the ventricles, coming from the lateral to the third and then fourth ventricle, and flowing through the subarachnoid space that circulates around the brain and spinal cord through the cerebral aqueduct. The CSF provides nutrients to the brain and cushions and cleans waste from the brain. Meninges are the membrane coverings of the spinal cord and the brain, and these include the dura, arachnoid, and pia mater that also help to protect and cushion. Now I'll discuss the types of brain cells that exist and go into neurons. Glial cells are support cells for the neurons. They outnumber neurons 10 to 1 and encompass various cells like astrocytes, which are the most numerous, and they supply nutrients, sync up neurons, and drive neurotransmitter release. There are oligodendrocytes, which wrap multiple neurons with myelin sheaths in the CNS. Their equivalent in the PNS are Schwann cells, which can only wrap around a single neuron axon. Ependymal cells line the CSF filled ventricles, and they make the cerebral spinal fluid, as well as facilitates neurogenesis. Microglia removes degenerating or dead neurons through the process of phagocytosis. Radioglia are glial cells that guide neurons through migration. Neurons are cells that pass information, and there are more than 80 billion of these in the brain, forming a large network of complex communication. Neurons have a soma or cell body which has the nucleus. There are also dendrites that receive information and axons and their respective terminals which transmit information to the next neuron. Neurites is a name given to the axons, axon terminals, and dendrites. The terminals are where neurotransmitters are released, and the synapsis is the space or gap between the neurons. Neurons are classified on various dimensions, such as their shape, the type of dendrites, like whether they are pyramidal or stellate, the number of neurites that exist on the neuron, such as whether it is uni, bi, or multipolar. Neurons are also defined by the length of their neuron. They could either be internuncial, long axons from the brain to spinal cord, or they could be interneurons, which are within a single brain region, thus having shorter axons. Neurons are classified by their neuronal connections, whether with sensory or motor neurons, and also by what neurotransmitters are used. Immunofluorescence is used by neuroscientists to stain cells and see what they look like. In regards to neurons, there are afferent and efferent neurons, which depends on the synapse of reference. Afferent neurons arrive at the synapse while efferent neurons exit the synapse. Finally, I will cover protein production. This is accomplished by DNA in the cell, which is too big to move outside the nucleus. Instead, messenger RNA are transferred out, carrying the message used to make proteins, called transcription. Translation is when mRNA is used to make proteins. Membrane-associated proteins are placed into vesicles, which travels to the Golgi reticulum and down the exoplasmic transport to the terminal. Cytosolic proteins take another path, where mRNA goes to the polyribosomes, to the smooth endothermic reticulum where folding takes place, and then to the Golgi reticulum. Kinesine is a protein that helps to transport the vesicles down the microtubules, and it relies or uses ATP.
In summary, this video covered a brief overview of the nervous system, such as the central and peripheral nervous system, and the autonomic and somatic, the sympathetic and parasympathetic. It also looked at how messages were sent whether through hormones or directly through PNS. We covered the blood-brain barrier, the cerebral spinal fluid, meninges, types of cells like glial cells, neurons, the parts and classification of neurons, and finally protein production. The source of this information is from my own summary of the Psy236 course, Biopsychology from Macquarie University 2018. Thanks for watching.